Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Always great to get off to a good start in conference play. Time for some early season action in the ACC. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Tennessee at Neyland Stadium. That's where our college football action set to begin. And now it's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Moss has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started.
He'll return it from the 6. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 31.
The Volunteers were really excited when they got this guy. They expect him to be a future star, a top recruit, a great talent. There's tackle number 1.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers.
Throws a bullet over the middle. Tackle at the 39.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Second and 2 coming up here. Ball on their own 39.
87's getting the ball. 87's getting the ball. 89, 98.
And he's taken down at the 40.
Carter picks up a yard on the play.
Run there as they work the outside.
Good yardage there on the option.
Outstanding play, well executed. Here it is, third down, and they come up big on the run.
We've got a 1st and 10.
Ball on the 47-yard line.
And they make the stop
right around the 44-yard line. Virginia Tech's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators.
Two-yard line.
So he found his receiver for the 1st down.
Well, they got to him in a hurry, but it was just a little bit too late. That's a nice 1st down pass.
From the 42-yard line, it's 1st down.
He's at the 30.
Tackle made at the 26.
So with that run, they pick up another 1st.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
From the 26-yard line, 1st down.
Throws complete. He's got space to work.
Brought down at the 15.
That's the beauty of running play action against zone coverage. In man, the defender has his eyes on the guy's covering. But in zone, the defender's looking right at the quarterback. That's why that play action worked so well for a 1st down. They weren't sure if it was a run or a pass.
complete. Brought down, nothing doing.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 15-yard line, it's second down. Quick pass. He steps up at the 5.
That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 70-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
So the score now, 7-0. Seller fields it at the 3. He's tackled at the 29. Washington's overall ability, Herbie, has got to drive you crazy if you're a defensive coach.
Yeah, you look at a defensive coordinator trying to slow this guy down, it's next to impossible. He can do so many different things, and today they're going to try to put pressure on him because if you sit back, he just makes too many things happen.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
Ready!
He's at midfield. Got some open field. To the 10. Touchdown, Vols.
That was simply sensational running. And it shows you what kinds of major things can happen when you have a good ground game.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. And down he goes at the 35. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Hand off, and he's met immediately. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Second down and 11. Ball on their own 34. Got it on the quick throw. And down he goes at about the 41.
That'll make it 35.
Roger, Roger. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
Wilson was the intended receiver on that pass. And that'll make it 4th down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended. And now the incompletion will force the 4th down and a punt.
Andy is the punter. Heading for the corner. And they push him out right around the 46-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
So it's 2nd and 10.
Ball on their own 46. He's taken down
right around the 40.
Yardage.
We played one quarter.
We're even at seven in this one.
Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point.
First and 10. Ball on the 26. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled at the 12-yard line. It right. Nice pickup. It's second and five here. Ball on the 7-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And this play is number 8 on the drive. They put everyone up on the line. Touchdown, Volunteers.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
Adds the extra point. Moss is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. He sailed that one high.
That's not a bad incompletion because he saw the blitz coming and just got rid of the ball to avoid losing yardage.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 25. They come out on an empty backfield. Looking for his man, incomplete. Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
This isn't how you get an offense going, and it can't help anybody's confidence.
Sellers is back deep to return. Sellers fields it at the 39. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Tennessee is up 7. He fights forward to about the 49.
Gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Second and 7. Ball on the 49-yard line.
gets out to about the 48-yard line.
Gain of 1 yard. Not over here. That makes it 37.
Not over here.
Right, Roger, Roger. Four down, four down. Hey, watch Sam, watch Sam. Check Mike 54.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gained, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Quickly to the tailback, and he shoved out of bounds around the 25-yard line.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on their own 25. And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
First down.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five look.
Going deep.
From their own 36-yard line, it's second down.
He might not be able to get the pass off.
And he is drilled at the 46. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. Complete, he's out of bounds. Well, these guys lost a lot of talent to graduation last year, and they've got to put some new faces in there. And this guy looks like he's the real thing, and he can help in that area.
Larry, Larry.
They'll spread the field with five wide. He launches one for the end zone. He brings it down. Touchdown.
Yeah, baby. It's my boy.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. Virginia Tech kicks this one off. Sellers fields it at the 7. He's knocked out of bounds at the 46-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Tennessee's going to take their first time out of the half.
Maybe 3 yards that time on the pass.
Very good job of coverage on the play. The freshman receiver made a nice play, but there was no room for him to run after the catch.
From their own 49-yard line, second down. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. Incomplete, and he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws, he's improved, but as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
Ready.
Got a man complete, and he's hit hard. Lawrence picks up 6 yards with that grab.
The Volunteers call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4.
Here we go, Jeff.
Now he tries to buy some time. Ball is loose. Fumble. Scoops up the loose ball, and they make the stop
around the 31-yard line.
And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
From the 32-yard line, second down. Here's the give. He's at the 20. And he hits him hard at the 14. He scrambled. They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
On the pass, touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Splits the uprights with the extra point.
So that's an 8-play, 49-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
The score now, 21-14. Moss gets set to kick this one away. Taken at the 5. Tackle made at the 27-yard line.
These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another 6 on the board here.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receiver. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Well, if you like offense, you loved our first half. Tennessee's lead is a touchdown.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like it is going to be a great second half. And boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we've got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 28. So we're just about ready to return to action. Tennessee up 7 points. He's scrambling. Washington picks up about 7 yards on the scramble. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. He heaves it deep, and he's hit immediately. It's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Brought down at about the 21. Throws it away. It's third and 7. Ball on the 21. Tennessee is up by a touchdown. He heaves it to the end zone, and he's got it. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A nice six-play, 73-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. They line up to kick this one away. Sands fields at the goal line, and he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Washington's consistency throughout this game really cementing his star status right now. Kirk, this is what we expected of him, and through 3 quarters, he's producing.
Well, we knew coming into this game, as you said, he's one of the top quarterbacks in the country. And how could he not be impressed by what we've seen up to this point? I mean, he's making good decisions with the football, getting his teammates involved in the offense, but most importantly, he's not putting his team in any kind of bad situation. He just seems to be managing the game and not letting this game manage him.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Fires out to his wideout, and he's taken down at the 40-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Fires it out. Tackle made right around midfield. He's tackled around the 40-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
gets to about the 31-yard line.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Run play, and he'll lose yards. From the 32-yard line, it's second down. Draw play, and the defense was ready for it. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Zips it to the back. Tackle at the 28-yard line. So they're going to go for it here. Scores! Touchdown!
They can't hold me, coach!
That's TD pass number 3.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
What's more amazing than anything else is that these guys are still losing. And he adds the extra point. Virginia Tech to kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. To be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half. Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Illegal touching. Offense.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
The penalty makes it second and 15. Tennessee is up a score. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
Throws in the middle. He's taken down around the 32-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, Tennessee leads it 28-21. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. They'll take it inside, but the defense is ready.
No gain on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. Caught with room to work. And down he goes.
42-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Got double tight. Double tight. Four down. Hey, watch that. Check mic 54.
Ready. Green 90.
Hot.
Green 90.
Makes the first down catch. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 48-yard line.
Well, it was third down, so they obviously had to get to the sticks, and they did just that with this little pass play.
From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. Tennessee is up seven. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
If these defenders continue to expose the line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Four down. Hey, watch that. Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
Let's go. 180.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Seems as though they didn't want to risk stopping the clock on an incompletion, so they kept it on the ground. Fourth down now.
And this is when you have to overpower the defense to keep moving the ball. That time, they didn't succeed.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. The Hokies were really mistaken if they looked at this game as a gimme.
Well, they've been in a dogfight the entire ball game. Let's see what they can do with this final drive. They still have time here to be able to pull out and try to get a win.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. Bring him down at the 46-yard line.
16 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46, and they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set. He's tackled at the 36.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Quick throw, and they make the stop at the 20-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Fires out to his receiver. Brought down at the 11.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
They'll spread the field with five wide. And a quick throw.
Touchdown, Hokies.
Thank you. They just didn't get the snap off in time. Here's the call.
Offense.
Will be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point.
Just under a minute left in the fourth quarter, and this game hasn't failed to disappoint. Tie ball game, locked at 28.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here.
Under a minute left in the game.
He's on a run. We're going to overtime. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Brought down at the 16-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
The 10. Touchdown, Volunteers. The extra point. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense.
Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So it's first down and an eternity.
Three down. Check 59. Mike.
throws in a hurry. And it's caught. And he scores. Touchdown.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game.
And he tacks on the extra point. We've got a dandy here, folks. We're heading to overtime number two.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line.
What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
And he's taken down at the 3-yard line. A gain of 8 on the carry.
That makes it second and 2.
It's second down and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
He makes the PAT.
First and 10. Ball on the 25. Throws it in a hurry.
And they make the stop
right around the 26-yard line.
Loss of a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that. Shadow and assume that that drop could come back to bite them, but this offense is able to put the ball into the end zone after that drop pass. This game could be over.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Going for it all to the end zone. Doesn't get there.
You don't think these guys get aggressive when it counts? Terrific hit to prevent the score.
So the offense comes up big, and now they're just an extra point away from a third overtime period.
I know we usually don't talk about extra points being big kicks, but they don't get much more important than this one.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up.
And he hits the PAT.
To a third. And extra points are no longer allowed. If anyone scores a touchdown, they've got to go for two.
Let's go! Green 19! Green 19! Easy!
Get to that quickly.
And he is drilled at the 9-yard line.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Now he's scrambling. Slides down. So the quarterback picks up about 8 on the scramble. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. So with the first possession in the third overtime, this offense takes it in for 6.
There's no resting easy yet. They still have to stay on the field and try to convert a very crucial 2-point conversion.
Tennessee up 6.
Give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
From the 33-yard line, second down. He's looking for 6. Almost intercepted. Throws left. The running back's got it. That's a great tackle at the 26-yard line. So they'll get one last stab at tying this up. Launches one for the end zone. Touchdown, Hokies.
We've seen a great performance by this quarterback, breaking the school record for most touchdown passes in a game.
So the offense is going to go for 2. So just like that, we're again tied up and looking forward to another overtime.
And they need to take the field again right now, so we'll see if they can carry the momentum into another scoring opportunity here in overtime.
Folks, we might be here all night. We're heading to another overtime. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. A 4-yard loss.
So that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Second and 14. Ball on the 29. Out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Carter picks up about a yard with that completion. They'll line up 5 wide receivers. Nice catch on that one. Tackle around the 15-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 15-yard line, first down. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. They'll bring him down at the 4-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Watch 14. Watch 14.
They come out in an empty backfield. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Just inside the five. It's second down. Touchdown, Virginia Tech. And they're looking to get 2 points here. Five wide. And they won't get the two. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Throws out to the running back, no good.
That makes it second and 10.
First and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Screen, and they got to him before he could get back to the line. Loss of about two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Two-yard line.
That's a that makes it third and goal.
This is where the defense makes a name for themselves. It's third down and goal from the one. Scrambling around. And down he goes, just outside the goal line. They come out in a five-wide set. Throws to the tailback, incomplete. Volunteers have to look at this somehow as a positive. Their star player had a great game. They just got to look to next week.
Yeah, it's tough anytime you lose a game to be positive, but if there is anything to be positive about, it's about that performance by this individual. He really did everything that he could do to try to win this football game. Unfortunately, the team ends up losing, but they can't build to the future around his abilities for sure.